Hey, Pascal here, nice to see you again. And this video is about how to fly your drone over the water or from a boat. I'm right now here at the beautiful Punta de Juan Centellas in Tenerife. It's an amazing place here, actually pretty good for drone flying, and it's one of the few places where you're actually allowed to fly your drone. So I think it's a good place to talk about how to fly your drone over the water. It's actually kind of a hidden place here. I found it through Google Maps as a 3D option, and even when I googled the name of the place, I didn't find much about it on the internet. So when you're in Tenerife and you want a place it's a bit more hidden where not so much tourists are, then this is definitely a good place to go. But anyway, let's go straight to the topic. So how do you fly your drone over the water and over boats? And you have basically three situations when you fly over water. This is the first situation is you're on the land and you're flying over the water. The second situation is you're flying from a boat that stands still, that's not moving. And the third situation, and the most difficult one, is to fly the drone from a boat that's actually moving. So this is very hard to do. But let's start with the most simple situation here. So how do you fly your drone over the water when you're on the ground? I must honestly say that flying your drone over the water is actually much less dangerous than flying it over the land, because there's not much you can crash into, right? Like, of course, sometimes there are some rocks or there are boats and you need to check this out before. But when you fly over the water, there's usually nothing you can crash inside. But when you fly over the land, there are buildings, there are trees, of course there can also be rocks, there are people, there are vehicles, probably a helicopter is appearing or something. Okay, this can be over the water as well. But it's much more dangerous to fly over land. I don't want to say here that drone flying itself is dangerous. In my opinion, it's not very dangerous as long as you fly a bit safe, but it's definitely safer to fly over the water. So a lot of people are actually pretty scared to fly over water because they think, oh, my drone will fall in the water directly and I will never see it again. But that's not true, to be honest. Like, flying over water is pretty safe. And I already mentioned some points. I think it's like, of course, when you want to fly over water, you have to watch for boats and rocks and stuff. And that's where your settings come into play. Like with every flight, doesn't matter if it's over the land or over the water. At first you have to set up your home point, you have to set your return to home altitude and your maximum distance and stuff like that. And so when you fly right from a beach or from rocks like that and you want to fly over the water, you should keep that in your mind. So the first thing that you do is think of what's the highest object that you can potentially crash in these areas. And you want to set your return to home altitude above this object. So let's say you fly over water and there are some boats, and yeah, of course you don't want to crash into the boats, and there's, let's say there's a big cruise or something, and the cruise is probably, let's say, I don't really know how big they are, but let's say 15 or 20 meters, so let's say more, then I would set my return to home altitude to 50 meters, simply because then I'm definitely high enough so that I wouldn't crash into any boat when my drone does a return to home, and probably I lose connection or something, that can happen. So this altitude is pretty good for that. What you should also watch for is not just the objects on the water, that's very important. It's also important to watch for palm trees and stuff like that. Because let's say the drone does a return to home and it flies a bit farther than where you're standing and probably hangs in that palm tree after that. So it's also good to watch for that. And you can do that pretty easily. You can just start your drone, you just fly above the palm trees that you're clearly above, and then you set your return to home altitude to the meters that your display shows you. So pretty simple. So if you stick to those simple rules and don't do something stupid, it's actually pretty safe to fly over water and you shouldn't worry too much about it. Of course, before you start, you should definitely check that you actually set your home point and that you have GPS, because otherwise your drone would probably do a return to home to another place and you don't want that. But that's also, it's the same like flying over land, right? Okay, I already finished the shot, but I forgot to say one little thing here about flying drones over the water, and it counts for every situation. That is how high you should fly your drone over the water. And I mean, you can see some of my shots where I actually fly the drone closer than under 1 meter over the water. And it's definitely possible, but you should always watch for waves. So if you have a lot of waves in the water, then you should definitely fly higher. And if the water doesn't move that much, then it's safe to fly low. Especially when you fly over lakes or rivers without much moving water, then it's pretty safe to do that. Otherwise, when you want to catch some waves that hit some rocks or something, you should be very careful. Before you fly the drone above that, you should watch the waves, how big they are, how high they go into the air. And you shouldn't just watch one or two waves, you should watch it for 5 to 10 minutes, because every wave can be a bit bigger than the other one, so that you see what the maximum height that the waves can reach is, or that the water reaches when the waves hit the rock. So that's very important, and when you have that, you're pretty safe. Just keep that in mind when you want to fly over the rocks, or when you want to fly like on to the rocks and then over it or something. Then you definitely have to raise the height of your drone, otherwise it can crash your drone. So keep that in mind also. So that's just for flying over water when you're standing on the beach or just on the ground. So pretty simple actually, but let's make it a bit more difficult. What if you want to fly your drone from a boat? And there are several things that you need to think of. At first, every boat is moving. Even if the boat is not driving, let's say you're in a long-tail boat in Thailand or so on, then the boat is still moving a couple of meters just from the waves. I mean, the boat is locked to one place, but it's moving a little bit. So definitely when you lose connection to your drone and it does a return to home, then it will definitely not land on the boat. And especially because the boat is going up and down all the time, it's moving a bit, it's not really safe or good to land the drone in the boat actually. The first thing that you should think of before flying a drone from a boat, doesn't matter if it's moving or not, ask the captain if you're allowed to do that. If you're not allowed to do that, let it be, because you will just get stress on the boat, and it's just not nice for all the people. And if something happens, the captain is not prepared to help you, especially when the boat is moving. So this is definitely the first point that you should think of when you want to fly a drone from a boat. Right before you even go to the boat, ask the captain if you're allowed to do that. Otherwise, it can get you into trouble. Flying a drone from a not moving boat is actually also pretty simple, because you're not moving. So the only very bad thing that can happen is that you lose connection, like the same when you're on the land, right? And then your drone should come back to you. And because the drone is the boat is not really moving, it's very likely that you will get the connection back when the drone comes closer to you, and nothing bad will happen. So actually, this is pretty simple to fly a drone from a boat, but of course the start and the landing can be a bit difficult, depends on what boat you are. For example, I've been in Bali and I was flying my drone from a motorboat, and I didn't watch in the air before, and there were actually some flags hanging out of the boat by the side, and I was getting up my drone, it was flying directly between those flags. Like, I was like, whoa, man, I had so much luck that it didn't crash. So the first thing when you fly your drone from a boat is that you watch in the air, watch what's above you, watch what's above the drone, and then you're sure if you can start from there or not. And there are also boats where it's actually not possible to start the drone right from the boat, and in that case you need someone who helps you. You need someone who holds the drone in his hands, and you need to give him instructions. Like, you have to tell him that when you say now, that he should leave the drone, but he shouldn't leave just because the propellers turn. Like, if you turn the drone on, it's not flying yet, just the propellers start turning. And if he stops holding the drone in this moment, then it will fall to the ground and probably into the ocean, right? So you need to give this helper clear instructions before, otherwise that can potentially damage your drone or even himself. So definitely give him a good instruction before. So what should you tell him? The first thing that you should tell him is that when the propeller starts from the drone, he should still hold it in his hand, because it doesn't mean that the drone flies now. So the first thing that you tell him is that, and that he should take it in both of his hands and hold it a bit farther away from his head and from his body so that nothing happens with the props. I mean, it's not very dangerous, but just tell it to him. Otherwise, maybe he holds it in front of his face or something. That could be dangerous. Don't want something like that. So it's important to tell him that. And then it's the best to show the helper how you fly your drone before, so that he can actually see, aha, the propellers are turning now, and just when you press up that the drone starts flying, that he knows how it works. Because then you can tell him, okay, like when you recognize a little pull from the drone, then you can leave it. Or when you say now to him, just leave it now, then he can also leave it. Because like when you are pressing up and he is holding it like, and he doesn't know what to do, but the drone is turning like hell, and when he loosens it, the drone is like poof, it goes in the air. And probably when there is something from the boat close to it, it could potentially crash in it. I mean, it's very unlikely, but it can happen. So definitely give a helper clear instructions how to do that, and then you can fly safely there. And don't try to fly your drone from a boat when there's much stuff around where it can crash, when the starting area is not level and stuff. Otherwise, it's potentially dangerous and your drone could fall directly into the water. Pretty important to keep that in mind. And then the next part when you fly from a boat is that you have to hand catch your drone. I was actually, when I was starting flying my drones from boats the first two times, it was from a long tail boat and a motor boat. And I actually landed the drone inside the boats, and like the second time was very close to crashing it, because there was not much space in the landing area, and the drone was like going from one direction into the other all the time. I had to control it against this movement and stuff. So it's just too dangerous to land a drone into a boat. Actually, one time it was not a real crash, so the drone didn't got damaged or anything, but it was falling into the boat. So It's not very nice to land a drone like that. But so what can you do? How can you land your drone safely into the boat? And this is basically, if you don't land it into the boat, what you do is you hand catch it. It's pretty easy. Even, I mean, the Phantom 4, for example, it doesn't look that small like a Mavic. The Mavic is more like, oh, land on my hand. Or the DJI Spark also, I mean, it has this landing feature on its hand, but it's probably not that good on boats because the boat is shaking, but it's another story. But from the Phantom, it looks a bit bigger, but you can actually grab your Phantom just on one of the legs, and with the other hand you can hold your controller and press the wheel down so that it lands, and it will stop turning the propellers after around 2 to 3 seconds, and then you can just put it anywhere and it's safe. So the safest way to land a drone on a boat is to grab it with your hand. So before you even think of flying a drone from a boat, please train on land to catch it with your hand. It's pretty easy to learn. Just fly it a bit above your head, so that when you get too close or the drone shakes a bit, that it doesn't crash into your head. But in a distance that you can easily grab it, and then just try it out like I told before. It's pretty simple. And but apart from that, it's pretty easy to fly a drone from a standing boat. There's nothing really dangerous about that. Of course, like when you come back, don't fly too fast and stuff. You don't want to fly into the boat, and always watch in the air around you that there are not any things around in the air where you can potentially crash into that you didn't thought of before. But if you keep these things in mind, it's also pretty simple. Okay, but now let's come to the pro level part here, which is flying a drone from a moving boat. So at first it all starts before you even start the drone, because like what I had one time is that I set my maximum flight distance to just 300 meters because I'm in Spain here. I didn't want to act against some laws here, so I regulated myself a bit with that. But the problem was, when I was flying right from the boat and the boat was moving, suddenly like after 300 meters the drone was standing in the air, but the boat was still moving. So there was a problem, and yeah, of course I solved it. I directly told the captain, please stop the boat and turn around. My drone is standing and it doesn't fly farther. And at the same time, I just went into the menu of my drone and I raised the maximum distance a bit so that I was actually able to fly the drone again. So, but in those situations, you need to react pretty fast, and that's not always good, especially if the boat moves a bit farther. So keep that in mind, and yeah, just do this little setting before. It's very important. And also your return to home altitude, it shouldn't be too low, because maybe there are other boats or something like that, you want to watch an eye for that. Yeah, and so this is definitely one thing you should do before. Do the right settings so that nothing badly can happen. You just need to think of how far around will the boat go, and you should set the maximum distance to that. Like, I would say, for example, in most cases 1 kilometer, like 1,000 meters or something, is okay. It shouldn't be a big problem, because actually, like, even 300 meters are pretty much. Okay, so much about the settings right before you start the drone. The next thing then is that you should start the drone when the boat is standing and not moving, because like when the boat is moving, it's much more difficult to start the drone, and it's more likely that it crashes against something. If you want to start the drone while the boat is moving, you should definitely stand at the end of the boat and not in the front. But let's say you start the drone in the front, then the boat is moving forward, crash into your drone, logically. So better if you start it when it's already moving, do it in the end. But I would consider even don't doing it. I mean, in most cases, your intentions of flying a drone from a boat is to follow the boat, maybe, or like when I was here in Tenerife, to film the whales and stuff like that. So even when a drone is standing, you should be clear about your intentions, because the more shots you make, and especially the more random shots you make, the more likely it's that you crash your drone. It's actually the same on land, it's not just on water. So all the time, every time before you fly your drone, you should definitely think of, okay, what do I want to make? Shot 1, shot 2, shot 3, shot 5, 10, whatever. But think of what shots you want to get before, and only do those shots, because like just flying randomly around without any plan is dangerous, and it's much more likely that you crash your drone in this moment. Actually, both drones that I crashed in my life, I crashed when I was just flying around randomly. That's why I don't do that anymore. It's okay if you leave a drone in the air a bit, when you just think, okay, I could do some more shots, but then just don't fly randomly around. Keep your drone in one place and keep a minute, think about it, what shot can I do now, and then do it, but don't fly randomly around. Pretty easy. Just a little tip by side here, but back to topic. So about flying the drone from a moving boat. So yeah, like I said before, be clear with your intentions, why you want to fly a drone from a moving boat, and only do this shot. Like when you want to follow your boat, and then start from a standing boat, then do your active track or something, set it all up so that it follows, and then you can give the captain the signal to start the boat, right? And it automatically follows. You get your shot, you can fly around the boat. It's very nice in active track. So like when you're in active track, you press to the left and right, then your drone is turning around the object. I love those shots, and it's also good with boats. You can do it pretty easy. But yeah, like it's your intention to do this shot. So when you do that, just only do this one shot until you like it, and then return to the boat. And when you want to return to the boat, first tell the captain that he should stop the boat. Also, while you still use active track or something like that, still while the drone follows the boat, because you don't want to get too far from the drone. And then when the boat stops, and then you can take the drone to the boat, fly very slow, grab it with your hand and land it. Pretty simple. So then you're absolutely safe. And I mean, the most dangerous thing when flying the drone from a moving boat is that you lose connection and the drone goes back to a home point that don't exist anymore, where it's only water, because it thinks like the home point is where the boat was before, but it isn't there anymore. And then you have a problem. So and there's one thing that you can do, not to prevent it, but to, yeah, let's say lower the risk. So for example, I would say I never lost connection to my drone under 300 meters. Like my first drone was a Phantom 3 Standard, and there I would say between 300 and 500 meters was usually anywhere when I lost connection. And like all the newer drones, you can easily fly over 500 meters away. I don't say that you should do that, because it's not legal in every country, or in most countries it's actually not. You have to keep line of sight to your drone, so don't fly over 500 or 300 meter, depends on the lightning conditions, on the weather and stuff. But yeah, just keep line of sight all the time, just to make sure to stick to the rules in the country. So of course, you cannot always prevent that you lose connection. It can always happen. I mean, it's very unlikely, to be honest, but it can happen. And yeah, we want to make sure that if it happens, that we can rescue it as good as possible. So what you can do to prevent that, or to make to lower the risk from actually crashing your drone in such a situation, is to reset your home point all the time, so that the drone wouldn't fly back to the original home point, like flying away from the boat, but that the drone is coming actually closer to the boat, or at least doesn't fly away too far. And you can easily do that with a function in your app. Like, you can reset the home function all the time while you're flying with a drone. And there are two options. You can set the home point to the point where the drone is right now, or you can set the home point to the point where you are right now, or better, to where your phone or your controller is. And then you make sure that the drone point moves. So I would recommend to do that every 150 to 200 meters. So when you watch on your display and you see that the drone is now 150 to 200 meters away from the last home point, then just go into the menu and reset the home point to the new position of your controller, not of the drone. Then you can make sure that at least when you lose connection, the drone doesn't fly too far away from the boat, and it's more likely that you get the connection again and you can safely land your drone on the boat. So this is a little tip here from me. Of course, on my first flight from a boat, I didn't think about that, and so I got into this trouble and I learned from that. So right now when I fly my drones from moving boats, I always stick to that. So, and that's basically everything. When you want to fly your drone from a moving boat, the highest risk is that you lose connection and it would go back to the home point. So reset your home point, and also all the time when you film from a boat, make sure that you have a helper to start your drone and that you can hand catch your drone when you want to land it. Pretty simple. And the rest is actually like nothing special. It's the same like on the ground. You keep track about your return to home altitude, about the maximum distance, keep the line of sight and stuff. And when you stick to all of those rules, like I told you now here, you are very safe to fly your drone from boats or just over the water. And of course, like always, don't be scared about doing stuff like that, because when you feel scared, when you don't feel good about it, you become a bit more insecure and then you're more likely to make risks. So I would recommend you to first start flying your drone from the beach, or at least from some rocks or something, but don't just start directly from a boat, so that you get used to that feeling a bit and that's all okay from you. Then second step, fly from a normal boat, learn to hand catch it correctly, because it's a little bit more difficult, because the waves shake your boat a bit and stuff, but it's also okay. And then you can try to fly your drone from a moving boat. And I mean, if you do everything right, if you follow all the tips that I gave you in this video, you are very safe and nothing bad will happen. So I hope you get a lot of great shots from the ocean or from rivers or from wherever you fly, and that you have a lot of fun with that and hopefully don't crash your drone. But I mean, yeah, like I told already, it's pretty unlikely that that happens. So I would say see you in the next video here. I will show you some more clips now from this beautiful place here. I actually forgot the name right now again, it's so difficult. But then see you in the next video. And of course, if you like this video and if you want to have some more tips about videography and drones in the future, then hit the subscribe button. And also, if you have some more questions about flying drones over the water or from boats and stuff, then just leave me a comment and I will answer your questions as soon as possible. Also, feel free to share the video. It's under the Creative Commons license, so you don't need to worry about that you get any problems or something. Then I would say, see you in the next video and do a lot of great shots.